Hey everybody, welcome back to Dirt Grace Outdoor Peace. I'm gonna do a kind of quick and dirty repair on my pond dam that's failing. I really don't want to get too close over here. See that big hole over there? The drain that I had with the stone in it isn't low enough, so now the pond is overflowing right there and it's washed all that out. So I'm gonna make a emergency spillway. It's gonna be an emergency for more than one reason. Is getting ready to lose the dam down there. I think I'm just gonna stay pointed this way and start cutting that in and laying the clay over here and push the clay down and try to get down to that hole down there. I can also use some of this down here, but I guess I'll just start digging this out. See if I can get down to any kind of decent material in here. That I was gonna do all summer and just never got to it. Some of this stuff I'm just gonna put in this hole so I don't have such a big crater over there. I know it's not good dirt, but at this point I don't really have a choice. As I get away from the bank here, it should start getting a little more solid. We just got just a few really nice days this week. And we've been just running around like crazy trying to get all these projects done while the weather's nice. And it's hunting season right now, so we've been doing some hunting and when it was cooler. And today's Thursday. This weekend it's gonna get a little cooler and rain, so I think right after the rain quits we'll get out and hunt Saturday, and then for Halloween and 1st of November looks really good for hunting, besides the chance of rain or snow. But then after that looks pretty good. It's supposed to clear back off and be mid to upper 40s, I think. Now that's actually some pretty good looking dirt down there. I don't want to go any deeper because the pond needs to fill a little bit more. So I'm going to push this off, try to get to where I feel safer. Like that hole right there, I need to fill that in. Just so I feel a little safer tracking down here. I made a mistake when I bought this property. This was washed out like 3 or 4 feet deep right here, and the same thing happened. That's what that big hole was from right there. So I dug a borrow pit over there and hauled the clay over and built that up, but I didn't put a pipe in. I just dug a little ditch and put rocks in there, and I shouldn't have done that. I should have, it's the water, because when this gets the, when this gets the big flood in the spring and in the fall, the water that feeds into this pond is all the drainage for probably, I don't know, 400 or 500 acres, maybe more. So it all, like right now it's dry. There's just a little tiny bit of water trickling in up there. But when we get back into the wetter weather, it's pretty much constant running water. So I'm gonna try to get back in position here. Yeah, I'm not gonna waste any of this stuff because it does have a lot of stone in it. Like I said, this is just kind of an emergency repair, because this is all I can think about. Like now it's gonna start raining a lot, and we're gonna be into hunting season. Even like the best part of hunting season, the rut should be starting to hit pretty good now. I don't want to be worried about this pond washing out. So this will make me feel good about getting this done and saving what's in there, because there's largemouth bass and turtles and everything else. So I just want to be able to get this knocked off. And then next year I have a plan for how I'm going to repair this and kind of expand on the pond a little bit. And then I have plans of cutting the banks back. I don't know if you can tell on camera how that bank is real steep. I want to cut the banks back so that it's nicer for us to walk up to the shoreline and get the shoreline cleaned up. The only thing I've done in the last few years was just brush hog down here, and I need to I think once I fix that next year, put a piece of pipe in, whatever dirt I can come up with, I'm gonna push on the back side of the dam and make that so I can maintain that. And this should all be parent material or virgin ground underneath here, so as long as I keep it wide and flat, the water should sheet drain over it. So hopefully it doesn't erode too bad. But it's gonna be better that there's erosion over here than instead of where it's so close to just washing the whole pond dam out down there. And this is going to be the only tricky part here, is that I'm going to be cutting off my access to push this dirt over there. I'll have to figure that out as I go, I guess. See how much dirt this thing can push. This isn't ideal, but I don't have any choice. I just don't want this thing washing out. I'm gonna try to salvage some of this stuff down here. I wasn't too far away from losing this thing. Thank you. like to get up there a little closer. What I'm going to do is cut more off of here so I can get some more of this a little bit better dirt. Thank you. try to get some a little bit better material and top that off. Because my right track is almost in the pond, and then I got a stone in the dirt there. Don't have such a big hole right there. Well, I'll just take more of this and just keep trying to cut out and just eyeball that drain and try to get a decent emergency drain there that isn't right on the corner of the dam. Next year, somewhere here, I'm going to put a pipe in and had to clear, I think I'm going to clear this brush back, and then I'm going to borrow the clay, dig a bigger borrow pit over there to borrow the clay from. That's the only thing, right? I don't want to go too deep right there because I want that thing as flat as possible. I will, I might have to get out, once I get some more of this dirt out, I'll probably get down there and just kind of eyeball across there, see what that looks like. Gotta fill this hole in a little bit. Better dirt right there, still not great. I think, as far as I know, this pond was built in the 80s. And they used the clay at a local factory for some kind of mold making. That's the stories that I've heard. The water ends up flowing out through there. And I don't want to. Backing that in good, but I'm gonna just keep laying some dirt up, and then I think once I get down to cutting that out more, I'll start the camera up again. Okay. Well, before it gets too dark, I wanted to show you progress I got here. I got this all filled back in. I tracked over it as best I could without going off the side there. Even though that's not the best of dirt, I'm pretty happy with getting this big hole packed back in. And so now I'm gonna
we're just running out of daylight, running out of weather, and so I'm gonna go down here, take a look at this overflow. It looks pretty even. Probably could go down more right here, but I think I'm gonna cut out. I'm gonna stay away from this right here, and I'm gonna cut more towards the excavator and keep the water away from the dam,